Got new speakers?
Yeah, come check them out.
All right.
Actually really good.
Okay, cool. We done?
I guess so.
We've been rolling for a while. Let's just go ahead and get started.
Yeah, I can't find anything. I can't focus. Okay.
We got an inquiry from username Gitch to do a speaker distortion video. So there's lots of other VFX tutorials of this kind, with like distortion stuff about
speakers for like music videos and crap.
But it's After Effects.
Okay, the first thing that we're gonna do, we're gonna add in the camera tracker.
I'm gonna put this over here so I can read it and make it look like I know something.
Yeah. Auto track this. I think that there should be more points, so we're gonna go ahead and turn this down a little bit. There we go. Now there's a decent amount of points here. For those of you who don't know, a camera tracker analyzes points of contrast and generates a single point that is tracked. And then it measures the parallax between all the points that it figured out, and it averages those and estimates the camera movement. Yeah, I mean, I know what parallax is, but I don't know how to explain it.
Which means you don't know what it means.
I know what it means.
Nope.
It's like,
no,
if you go like this, and then you move your head faster than the other hand.
Perspective shift.
Yeah, that's...
We don't know what parallax means, so look it up.
Then you go to your camera, and Jesse said this was probably 22 millimeters. So punch that in if you can. If you get an average resolve error that's over 1.1 or 1 pixels, then you're going to probably want to add more tracks. You can delete any. Then, once you're done, you can go to export and hit export. It sets up a scene for you. We put that in there. Go into the camera 3D1. Here, we'll pop this up in this window so you can see this. And you'll see how it has this background right here. And the final output has the actual image there. We don't want that. We want just an alpha panel, so then when we add objects in, we can merge them separately. Those little lines, that is just this ground plane. Does not matter. Go into image, and you have to unlock it. It generates a lock, and now you have a blank alpha. So now we're going to take this merge, and we're going to take this, and we're going to go right on top. Now we're going to add an image plane 3D, like so, and we're going to take this, and we're going to plug it into the merge 3D. And now we have this.
A white box.
A white plane. This would be a box. Because it's a box, it's 3D. Why is it colored like that? Why are there so many inputs? What is that? It's slipping a lot, and that's because it is actually behind the location of the speaker. Here, roughly, is where the speaker is. Needs to come forwards. Try to angle it. Now that should be lined up pretty well. And if we go here, it's not slipping anymore. Pretty sick.
Yeah.
I'll take this and turn this down so you can see. Make sure your plane is covering this whole thing. Just there's not like a poking out bit here. And add a ellipse mask. Then you can scale it and move it. And
now it's a circle.
Yeah. It's a circle that moves with the speaker. And that's pretty cool.
It's a revelation, y'all.
We've already done this once, and then we found out that we were recording on the laptop audio instead of the mic.
So basically we wasted an hour. Yeah. Unlink the point cloud.
Particles.
Permitter.
P.
Emitter.
Emitter.
P-E. Particle renderer.
Yep, that's exactly right. Particle render.
Because you can't have particles without the non-particles. And there's a living plant that's supposed to be delivered today.
I'm grabbing a plant in a box.
Hey guys, I'm Miles. I am bald. And I don't got no hair. I found a lighter somewhere. Our Damon Speed branded candle. Which you can order nowhere. And now we have a candle. No! Ow. I had a dance party with it and then I burnt myself.
It's almost like lighters are meant to be played with.
Alright, let's get back to the video!
The light's dead. Did you turn it off?
No, I told you that.
What, you did?
Oh, Miles, the light died. My thumb actually really hurts.
From the fire.
Okay, let's continue.
Particle emitter, and we take that and we move it to the position that we had from the speakers.
It's next to fire.
Face the
of
screen,
course
Miles.
It's going
face
to get
the screen,
hot.
Miles.
And you go into region, and then you change the size down to an infinitesimally small point. Okay, now we're going to add...
S-H-A-P-E. You're really bad at this, though.
And a shape 3D.
That wasn't so hard, was it?
Replicate 3D, boom. And actually, before we plug that in, we're going to take this number and we're going to turn it down to 0.1 just to get much more responsive. Because we don't want it to freeze on us.
Now
we go do shape 3D.
Taurus.
Taurus.
Taurus. Not to be confused with a thesaurus.
The easier way to do this is just add a transform and you get more freedom with the way you move it around. Works. And you scale this.
What you do?
Stop myself.
Or Jesse.
Now you can unplug image plane 3D because this is in the right position. Now what you want to do is you want to take your transform and you're going to want to rotate this crap into the right position so it lines up with the speaker. Boom!
Boom!
There's a thing in a thing spot. Of course
you
I don't touch
you
grass.
You would go outside and be like, friggin', this grass simulation isn't as good as the other one I saw.
Wait, really?
Yeah, it's fine.
No!
Now we know what Premiere Pro users feel like.
Now what we're going to do is we're going to go into the particle emitter settings, and we're going to go into the velocity, and we're going to turn this up. And now they shoot off to the side. It's obviously not spitting them in the right direction. So you have to take the angle, and you have to rotate that, and then take the angle Z, and you have to rotate that. Okay, now we're going to go into the style section. We're going to change this to blob. And now it spits out little Cheerios.
Yeah.
Go into size controls. Then we can fix the size and bring it back up to something that looks good. When these go off camera, we do not need them anymore. So you can take down the lifespan. Here's a cool thing. This little section right here says size over life. So you can do something like this, where they start small and then they spread out over time, as sound waves do.
Lighting!
Yes, correct. Now we're gonna come up with some cool lighting. And this is gonna be...
It's like one of those cringy kids shows. Yes!
Yeah!
Correct!
This will probably be the biggest influence on how the displacement comes together. So you're probably gonna be fiddling with this long after, but we're gonna introduce it now in the camera tracker 1_renderer. And then you're gonna go and check lighting. So you don't need to check shadows. That may be an issue if you do. Now we add
straight to myself.
A point light, and we can plug that into the merge 3D. And you can change the intensity, maybe to like 2, and you can move it around. And look at that.
Yay.
Now you have really crappily rendered 90s graphics to light your...
PS2 graphics.
Your things.
It's like a little inflatable tube that you shove children in.
So now I have something like this. And this is starting to come together. This is actually pretty cool. Whoa!
Whoa! Whoa!
Little wormies. Okay.
I get more shellfish. I want to hold this.
It's a file.
No, files are in computers.
Why are you filing my desk? Have you ever used a file before? Welcome to 101 Tools.
I can really kill you right now.
Jesse.
Also, this is payback for you setting fire to my desk.
I
just got my desk.
It never,
later,
it never was on fire. You can also add an ambient light, and that will just brighten up the darkness. You can go into the shape 3D, and you notice that there are these vertices on it, and we don't really want those. They're not going to be a big deal, but if you can, you can turn up base subdivisions. We're going to finally move away from all of this junk, so if you want to pretend like you're neat, you can just go Control G, go F2, and rename this to 3D crap that were hopefully done with. Now, we're going to add a displace Now we have this, and we're going to use this as our displacement map. See what happens when we plug this up?
Oh. Yo!
You get a little bit of displacement. See, look at that. You'll notice that when we change this, it kind of stretches it out in one direction, and we could only take this in either direction once, and that is not how things would actually be refracted. So, in this part of the video, I explain how to create a pretty decent looking distortion effect by stacking vector distortion, displacement, and chromatic aberrations all together. And that works, but it's rather inconvenient and not that good, just to be honest. Just don't do that. There's a free plugin or script for DaVinci called Reactor. It comes with lots of effects. I'll put a video on how to install that. And once you have that installed, just go into Workspace, go to Scripts, Reactor, Open Reactor. Once that's open, you can just see the sheer number of different effects that this has. Like, every single one of these is totally free, so there's really no reason why you wouldn't want to download this. It's just amazing. You can type chromatic displacement, and what you'll do is just check that, and then say not right now, then you can press X, and you may need to restart. I don't think you have to for this effect, so you should be good. It's exactly like Red Giant's chromatic displacement. It's just free. So it replaces all of those effects, and it's all interactive, so it's just instantly far more realistic, and you can create some really, really sick effects with this. Yeah, definitely get that. Something else we should do is add a vector motion blur. Wait, no, optical flow, then vector motion blur if you have them in opposite position. It won't do anything. Yeah, and
that's the one thing I know how to do in Fusion is I removed all of this, and those are the only two things that are in my bar.
Well, you can do that.
Yeah, you can create like different presets to create new tools.
But if you don't like the excessive blurred distortion that's going around the edges when you do this, you don't have to. You can just turn it off. This is really the base of the effect. You could stop here. You don't need to go in and do all these crazy other things. Electricity, which is pretty gnarly.
Can I sand your fork down? Or like file your fork down to a spoon?
How would you file a fork into a spoon? You know, that I was gonna originally just walk through all of this. But
that's gonna be like a 30-minute video.
Exactly, that would be like an hour long. So much stuff is going on. So here, I'm taking this, which is just an alpha channel, and then I'm just previewing alpha here, which is, I'm basically just turning this into a full-on alpha channel. So then we're inverting this color, and then we're going to edge detect, so we just get these channels here, which are two crispy edges.
Oh, okay, that's actually genius.
Yeah, I didn't come up with this, I'll be honest.
It's fine.
But then we merge noise in, break it up a little bit, and then we have a displacement node, and then boom, and we get that. And then we throw on a glow, and then we throw on a lens blur in the areas that would be inside of it, so it looks like it's being refracted.
Dude, by that is cool.
By the actual tube that gets merged on top. And now there's lightning, which is pog.
Please don't say that.
And then we bought chromatic aberrations, because those
chromatic aberrations. Yeah. That's the only explanation you need.
Look at that.
Gorgeous.
Just nice.
Gorgeous.
Oh yeah, and also in this glow, there's an ellipse here that's massing around this just to create like an electric-y, static-y look the grid. See? Boom. Boom. Very cool. Magic mask. Boom.
I love the magic mask.
It's just that wrote it out. Edge detect. Soft glow. Alpha match ring and glow.
Oh, that's cool.
And then that's just applied as a screen, I'm assuming. Oh, linear dodge, never mind. We got reactor plugins here. Also, we got lens reflections because every single shot in the whole world I put lens reflections on.
Oh, yeah.
It's just good. Oh, analog damage, this is a kind of cool look that you can go with if you want. It gives it a retro-ish noise type deal. Makes it look like glitchy, you know? And then we also have camera shake. So whenever one of these like swings by the camera, I keyframed it, so now it goes and shakes a little bit. There is one other thing I want to talk about. Here's an image plane that I added. Oh, voice crack. there's an image plane that I added.
Added.
Like this. And then on top of this, we just mask it. And this is lined up with the front face of the speaker. And then we have a flicker addition. So what we're doing is we're just adding a little bit of electrical flicker, like automatic brightness and whatnot to that. So yeah, you can see a little bit, but it's very subtle, but it just adds a lot.
Oh, this.
Oh yeah, the mic. We're gonna want that. All
right, okay. That's probably fine.
Oh yeah, Instagram. Go check that out if
we
you
already
want.
Did a tag, Miles.
Oh yeah. Go check us out on Instagram.
We are building an entirely practical monster.
This is a leg.
Put it away, Miles. Oh, and I don't know if we mentioned this at all, but he's bald now.
I look a little bit different.
Sarcasm. We've said it 5 times.
Well, we said it 5 times, but then
but
we like re-recorded like 5.
Okay. Okay. Well, hope you enjoyed the video.
Ow, mother f***er.
That was the accident. I don't want to go to Mexico no more, more, more. Hey. I should post that on my netto. All right.
Mr. White.
Yes, science.
Yes, science. Okay, stop.